Hey CHC, welcome to TPTS Chapter 7, where today we're going to talk about rest and recovery. So week after week, day after day, we're all putting the work in the gym, but all this work is pointless if we don't rest. So rest comes in various forms, which we're going to talk about today. We can look at your sleep patterns, your hydration status, nutritional intake, your stress levels outside of the gym, off days, and deload weeks. So all of these things, they need to be considered in order for you to reap the greatest benefits from your training. Studies show that your performance will increase with relative rest after you work out. And without this rest, your muscles won't recover, you're gonna have hormonal imbalances and risk of overtraining, which is dangerous like we've talked about before. We've talked about your hydration status and rehydrating after you work out, but we're also going to look at nutritional intake after we work out. So in CrossFit, obviously we know that we work out at a high intensity, and with high intensity workouts or really long training sessions, we want to refuel with carbohydrates, because with these training sessions our bodies are using carbs as our fuel source. So after working out, we want to put those carbs back into our body, and we want to do it as soon as possible, because that's when our body is ready to take those carbs and put them back in to get ready to use them for your next training session. Also, sleep is something that needs to be considered. So everyone needs a different amount of sleep. We've all heard the different recommendations, but I personally would recommend getting at least 7 hours of sleep per night. Some of us might need more than that, and some of us might be just fine functioning with less than 7 hours of sleep. But what needs to be remembered is you should at least get that 7 hours of sleep and the same consistent 7 hours every night, and use that as your time to recover, because that's the only time that your body's going to be recovering, and that's, again, while you're sleeping. Lastly, don't shy away from off days or taking deload weeks. Recovery and improvement is not gonna happen faster at all if you don't take time away from the gym. So I would say once a week you take one day off, and then one week per month, you're taking a deload week, where you're decreasing your volume, or your intensity, or decreasing the weights of the weights that you're choosing in workouts. So last thing I'm gonna leave you with is a quote from my college track and field coach in relation to rest and recovery. And what he would tell us would be, in music, the pauses between notes are just as important as the notes themselves. That's all I have, CHC. Thanks for tuning in to TPTS Chapter 7. Have a great day.